Hey, crossword fans! Today we're going to be solving the New York Times crossword for Thursday, October 13th, 2022. Alright, let's get started. One across. Extended feature of Hey Jude and Layla? Well, they do have long solos, don't they? Is it just going to be a solo? Let's see if we can build through that. Consumer's energy source informally. Consumer. Is this like an energy company? I'm not sure what they're asking for here. Old music halls. I guess this could be Odia, the plural of Odeon. That's kind of a tricky plural there. Glue amounts often. It's not a lump of glue, is it? That doesn't sound right to me. Go on, do something funny. And this is an equivalent phrase. I want this to be like, make a joke or entertain me. None of those fit. I guess it's possible we have rebuses today. Mankind biblically. Is this gonna be Adam? Is that right? Does Adam stand in for mankind in the Bible? 16-ton singer often. So maybe this is not talking about a specific singer of 16 tons. I think I know the version by Ernie Ford. Maybe this is going to be something more like baritone. Baritone. Maybe we have tone in a rebus? Is this a B? Consumer's energy source. I have no idea. This would be an R? Amounts. It seems like it should be plural, right? Maybe this is an S? Glue. Maybe this is basso? Is that right? Boy, I'm not sure. Do something funny. Shouldn't this be amuse me? Yeah, so this is not solo. Amuse me. I wonder if it's a coda? That would be a long ending to the song. Energy source. Is this carb? Carbon? Is that right? I don't know about that. This could be dabs, dabs of glue. Sunset shade, MT. Is this the state code for Montana? Sunset shade. Interesting, and it looks like it's pointing to a revealer. Dress nicely with up. I think you can tog up. I think that means to dress nicely. Props can build it up. I guess if you get a lot of propers, that could build up your ego. That's kind of funny. Is this going to start with debut? C-A-D-B, that can't be right. What's going on with these theme answers? Sorry, blank sorry? Is that sorry, not sorry? Very unrepentant. Heat setting in brief, and it's pointing to this. It's played in the five across informally. I wonder if this is going to be a joke about the basketball team, the Heat. They would be in the NBA. That would be a heat setting. That's very funny. Okay, so this would be something played in the NBA informally. I guess that could be b-ball, right? That would be an informal way to say basketball. EastEnders broadcaster with the. Is that going to be the Beeb? The BBC? Extra abbreviated. I really want this to be additional. How do you abbreviate that? Is it DDL? Is this the Oxford English Dictionary? Meaningful work for short. Yeah, this is wordplay. So this is not about a poem that has a lot of meaning. I think it's a book that has a lot of meanings of words. That would be the Oxford English Dictionary. So what is this gonna be? Sunset Shade. MT. What is the capital of Montana? Is it in here somewhere? It looks like it needs to be rebutted. Sunset Shade. Is this an anagram of the capital of Montana? I wonder. I wish I could remember the capital. Isn't it Helena? So it's not going to be the capital. Maybe it's a city in Montana? Man, we're way out on a speculative ledge here. Let's keep filling in some new answers here. Start of an objection. And this looks like Texas. Sunset Shade. Rebutted doesn't make sense for Sunset Shade. I'm not sure if we can take this clue at face value. Start of an objection. Let's see if we can get some help building up into this corner. Best New American Play Award. Is that an Obie? I know that's an award for off-Broadway plays. Do Something Amazing for Another. I don't know how you would describe that. Gives blank attempts. Is that gives a shot? That's giving an attempt at something. Unequaled ever. It seems like there's a lot of possibilities here. Opposite of an exception. Well, wouldn't that be the rule? I guess not. Of an exception. Maybe it's a norm. Yeah, that makes sense. Longtime CBS procedural. Isn't that NCIS? I've never really watched that show. Sounds exciting, sincerely or sarcastically. Is that, oh wow? Yeah, that could be taken both ways. Going both ways, speaking of going both ways. What is that gonna be? I'm not sure. Documentary Now, cable channel, originally. Originally. I'm not sure. It seems like something's wrong here. I wonder if this is oh fun instead of oh wow. And then this could be IFC hosts the planets for one. It's not like a sonata. I want it to be some kind of music. SU? Congress created a media giant. Congress? Is it NBC? Was that created by Congress? Could that be right? Going both ways. I really want this to be reciprocal. That would fit too. That looks really good. Maybe this is a suite. Yeah, I think it is about music. This is going to be NPR. That makes more sense. Booty spot, and this is wordplay. I'm not sure if we're going to be able to figure it out. This is going to be Pennsylvania. Booty spot. Manhattan component. Okay, they're probably talking about the cocktail here. This is probably going to be rye whiskey. Cheer. What is going on with these theme answers? We might have to get the revealer in order to figure this out. This is very tricky. About up to here, an equivalent phrase. I really want this to be yay high. Yeah, they were about yay high. That's a fun bit of fill there. Well, this is going to be another theme answer too, isn't it? They're the pits. Arizona. I have no idea. Dispensed without. That should be meted out. All right, well, we're making progress in the non-theme part of the puzzle. Blank milk. Is it malted milk? I'm not sure if that's right. Painful effort. It's not a tribulation. It's not a trial. Evidence provider for some citations. Are they talking about a traffic citation? Is this going to be a police officer? I don't know if that's right either. And this is going to be another theme answer. Seoul, Utah. Withdraw. It seems like there's a few options here. Jamaican sprinter Thompson Hira with 5 Olympic golds. I don't know this person's name. Did some campaign work. I guess it could be called if you're calling voters. That doesn't feel right to me. Ready informally. I have no idea. Move informally? Is this going to be realtor speak? This could be relo. Maybe that'll help on these acrosses. Did some campaign work. It's not cold called. What is this? Sunset shade. It would help so much if we knew how this theme was working. Wait a minute, isn't Butte a city in Montana? And maybe it's being added to a sunset shade? That could be red, right? Butte in red. Maybe this is carb. Is it really carbon? That's crazy. I guess maybe it could be carbohydrate instead. That could be something you're eating if you're that kind of consumer, if you're eating carbohydrates. That makes more sense to me. Okay, so maybe we figured out how this theme is working. We're adding cities in states to a traditional crossword clue. Start of an objection. Okay, so this needs to be a city in Texas. I think it's going to have to start in the middle. I don't think the city could start at the first letter. So maybe we have a city that starts with L. Could it be Laredo? And then we would have two more letters to make start of an objection. Let's see, Laredo. Start of an objection could be but, right? Blared out. Okay, well, that is a sensible bit of language. That seems okay. Rebutted, blared out. All right. Unequaled ever. Okay, so maybe this could be all time. You're the all-time greatest. Okay, so there needs to be a Pennsylvania city. I see Erie here. Yeah, that could be Erie. Cheeriest. So that would leave us with what for booty spot? Chest. Yeah, I guess they're talking about pirate booty. Booty spot, that's very funny. What do we have here? Do something amazing for another. I'm not sure what this is gonna be. Well, we did get a lot of help here with blared out. Let's see if we can make some use of that. Like lays. Well, lays are made of flowers, so they could be floral. Was laid up. I wonder if this is ailed. If you're laid up, you're sick. Many morality tales. I think these are going to be fables. Serve as a go-between. I think this should be liaises. No, that would be serves as a go-between, right? Liaise. No, that's not the right tense. I'm not sure what this should be. Churchill portrayer in 2017's Darkest Hour. Was it Gary Oldman? I don't know who else could fit here. Harry Twin in a Bible story. I think this is probably going to be Esau. The hirsute Esau. In the mail. That's got to be sent. I think it has to be Oldman. I've never seen Darkest Hour. Was I spelling liaise wrong? How do you spell that? Is it another I? Oh, maybe I was just spelling liaise wrong. There we go. Devil's bargain, so to speak. Is that a bad deal? Fruit liqueur from Italy? Is that going to be limoncello? That's really good. I really like limoncello. So we have laden, encumbered. That's right. It may be hard to follow. A good act could be hard to follow. All ears. That should be alert. attempts. That's got to be tries. Okay, we're making progress. Actress Harper of No Country for Old Men. Ooh, is this the main character's wife? I don't know if I know this actress. Bluff say? That could be a lie. This is ambiguous. This could be talking about a bluff at a beach. Okay. Their scores are on some college applications. Is it GEDs? Does that make sense? I think maybe it makes sense. Yeah. Sounds of Realization. That's gotta be Oz. They're the Pitts, Arizona. All right, it's looking like we maybe have Mesa, Arizona, and then they're the Pitts. That could be Holes, maybe? Those would be Pitts. Yeah, and we have Home Sales. Okay, that's kind of related to Relos down here. It doesn't seem like these new phrases really have anything in common with one another. Rebutted, blared out, cheeriest, home sales. Yeah, they seem like random phrases. Maybe this is Tess? Throw out. Yeah, that could be toss. Enjoyed something with relish, say. I don't think they're talking about relish made with pickles. I think you're just enjoying something. It could start with ate, right? Could it be ate a lot? I don't know about that. Go to. Is it see? You're seeing a movie, you're going to a movie? It could be. Clairvoyance claim. Yeah, that could be extrasensory perception. Isolates in a way. Shouldn't that be silos in a business context? Yeah, let's try silos. It's not aid into, is it? A bird in flight for Lufthansa. That's their logo. They have a flying bird logo. Birds whose eyes don't move. I'm gonna guess that's owls. Maybe that's why they have to turn their heads so much. Apt rhymed for fit. Is it snit? That's kind of funny because they both mean little temper tantrums, right? Lumpy citrus. That's gonna be an ugly fruit. After, before. I guess they're looking for a prefix that means after. That could be post, right? This will be aided up. Yeah. It's not about literally eating. This could be enjoying anything with relish. Yeah. Okay, so it looks like we have a town in our revealer. That's good because we have towns or cities in states here. Run off. Or how to make the answers to 17, 21, 34, 44, and 53 across fit their clues. Okay, so this has to be some kind of adding a town, right? Run off. It should be skip town, right? And that does make sense because to make sense of the original clue, you have to skip the town that's been added. Yes, okay, that definitely makes sense. And skip town does mean run off. Very good. Okay, let's see if we can finish this last theme answer down here. Some items in purses for short. I guess that could be IDs. Squeezed out should be eked out. Bottle blank? Is that bottle fed as a baby might be? 15 across focus abbreviated. The Oxford English Dictionary's focus should be words, maybe? Is that right? Careful where you open this indicator. Yeah, this could be not safe for work. All right, let's see if we can get this last theme answer. Soul in Utah. I would want soul to be alone with this N-E at the end, but we can't put an L here, can we? That doesn't make sense. Utah. It's not going to be Salt Lake City. I don't know that many cities in Utah. What is this? B-E-A-H. Do something amazing for another. Is it be a hero? Man, that was tough to parse. Okay. We didn't get any extra help here. Evidence provider. citations. Is this citations in a book? I'm not sure. We did get an extra O here. Soul. It really seems like it wants to be loan. Reciprocal. I think a reciprocal has to be right. Have we looked at everything here? Painful effort we have. Poet who originated the phrase, for whom the bell tolls. Yeah, this is John Donne, I believe. That's a really good poem. No man is an island. Oh, maybe this is radar. It is about police providing citations. It's traffic cops using radar to catch speeders. Whew, okay, that's gonna help. Blank milk. Ooh, I'm still not sure about this one. Painful effort. Is it a travail? That is a $10 word. What is this? Oh boy, do I just not know this city in Utah? That might be. Oh, I spelled John Dunn's name wrong. This should be an O. Is this gonna be provolone? Oh yeah, Provo is a city in Utah. Oh man, it's not in the middle. It starts at the beginning. And then loan. Oh, that was so tricky. All the other ones are different. The city is in the middle somewhere. Oh my goodness. What a tricky one to end on. Okay, maybe it is malted milk. What is this? Withdraw. That could be recant, as you would a statement. I don't know, is it Blaine? PRB looks weird. Ready informally. Shouldn't that be prep? So this is Elaine. There we go. And this should be polled. Did some campaign work. That makes sense. All right, let's throw this P in there and see if that'll do it for us. Okay, a Thursday puzzle in 28 minutes. That's a little bit on the long side for a Thursday, but it took us a while to catch on to this skip town theme. Yeah, we were thinking early on that there had to be something to do with cities in states because we were getting state codes in the clue. But I was thinking capitals, and that kind of threw us off. It was very hard to see that these were other cities in these states, not necessarily capitals. So we had Butte, Montana, Laredo, Texas, Erie, Pennsylvania, Mesa, Arizona, and Provo, Utah. And in order to make sense of all of our theme clues, we had to skip town. Yeah, we had to skip over the town, and that would give us our traditional answer. So we had red for sunset shade and so on. Yeah, that was a pretty tough one to see, but once we finally caught on, we were able to fill out our theme answers pretty quickly. I think as far as the rest of the fill goes, the best stuff was probably these long downs. Reciprocal, travail, and limoncello were all pretty nice. I did like some of the ambiguous language we had in some of these shorter answers. Heat setting in brief for NBA, that's a nice misdirection. Same with props can build it up for ego. And also this very ambiguous bluff, say, for lie. Well, it's about time for me to skip town, but don't worry, I'm gonna be coming back at you tomorrow for the themeless Friday puzzle. All right, I think that's gonna do it for now. I'll see you next time.